Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Students Oriented Anatomy. I'm Dr. Saira Jawed. The content and the pictures in this lecture are taken from the references as shown here. This lecture is in continuation with my previous lectures on the topic of histology of epithelium. Taking into account or considering the most superficial layer or the top layer in a stratified epithelium, we name the epithelium as stratified squamous or stratified cuboidal or stratified columnar. The other type of stratified epithelium or the other type of compound epithelium is transitional epithelium. It is a special variety of compound epithelium because it has got different features as compared to rest of the stratified epithelium. Now we are going to discuss each type of stratified epithelium one by one in detail. We will discuss stratified squamous epithelium. As the name indicates, stratified squamous epithelium. Stratified means it has got multiple layers. And squamous means that the topmost layer is squamous in shape, or the cells are squamous in shape on the topmost layer. So seeing the state of most superficial cells, there are two subvarieties of stratified squamous epithelium. First is keratinized, which is also known as cornified, and the second one is non-keratinized. The first subvariety of stratified squamous epithelium is keratinized epithelium. The cytoplasm of the superficial cells in stratified squamous keratinized epithelium contain keratin filaments. So what is keratin? Keratin is a kind of protein which fills the superficial cells in case of keratinized squamous epithelium. These surface cells which are filled with keratin lose their nuclei and become dead and flattened. The intercellular space between these keratin filled cells contain waterproofing glycolipid. This type of epithelium is present on the surfaces which need protection from abrasion and desiccation. The epidermis of entire body surface is included in its example. Especially, the epidermis of hands and feet contains keratinized squamous epithelium. Now the other subvariety is non-keratinized squamous epithelium. The surface cells in this kind of epithelium are not dead. They are flat and are nucleated. The cytoplasm either contains no keratin or there is very little keratin present. Therefore, we call it as non-keratinized. This type of epithelium lines the surfaces where abrasion is there, but the surfaces remain wet. Examples include oral cavity and esophagus or food pipe. The other subvariety of stratified epithelium is stratified cuboidal epithelium. Being stratified, it contains multiple cell layers, and the topmost layer is cuboidal. Which you can easily see in this diagram, and there are multiple cell layers as compared to simple cuboidal epithelium having only a single layer of cells. It forms a stronger lining of ducts in the body and has got very limited distribution. Being present only in some exocrine glands like pancreas. This yellow colored organ shown here is pancreas. It lines the stratified cuboidal epithelium, lines the larger ducts of pancreas and some salivary glands which produce saliva. The ducts of these glands contain stratified cuboidal epithelium through which the saliva passes and comes into the oral cavity. The other example is the ducts of sweat. The third subvariety of stratified epithelium is stratified columnar epithelium. As the name indicates, it also contains multiple cell layers, and the superficial cells or the surface cells are column shaped. In this diagram, you can see that the nuclei show that there are multiple cell layers. This kind of epithelium is present in certain parts of the male urethra and also in the conjunctiva. Conjunctiva is a thin membrane that lines the inner surface of the eyelids and the white area or the sclera on the eyeball. My dear students, now I'm going to tell you how are we going to identify with certain key points in our mind the epithelial tissue or which type of epithelial tissue are we viewing in the microscope? We identify the epithelial tissue or the epithelium with the help of PLS. P for packing, L for layers, and S for shape of cells. If the cells we see in the microscope are closely packed, then the tissue is epithelial tissue. If it is loosely arranged or if the cells are loosely arranged, then the tissue is connective tissue. Usually the boundaries of cells are not visible. Only the nuclei or the purple dots are visible. So you can see that the purple dots, which are the nuclei, are arranged close together or are far apart. Right now, we are dealing with the epithelium. So the next layer or next point of identification is layers. Either there is a single layer or there are multiple layers. If there is a single layer, then we call the epithelium as simple epithelium. But if there is multiple layers, then we call it as stratified epithelium. The next point is of shape of cells. If In a simple epithelium, the cells are of squamous shape, then we call it as simple squamous epithelium. If they are cuboidal shape, we call it as simple cuboidal epithelium. If they are columnar shape, then we call it as simple columnar epithelium. But if we have identified several layers of cells, then we will see the topmost cell layer. If the topmost cell layer are squamous shaped, then the epithelium is stratified squamous epithelium. If the topmost cell layer is of cuboidal shape, then it is stratified cuboidal epithelium. If the topmost cell layers or the topmost cells are columnar shaped or column shaped, then we call it as stratified columnar epithelium. I hope this PLS helps you or is going to help you to identify the epithelial tissue under the microscopes. My dear students, if you like my effort, then do share and subscribe, and also give constructive feedback in the comments section below. Transitional epithelium is the special variety of stratified epithelium. It appears like this in the microscope. It lines the urinary tract. It can withstand the stretch produced by distension of the urinary passages due to storing and passing of urine. It prevents the reabsorption of urine, and it doesn't add There are two varieties of transitional epithelium, which is also known as urothelium. Either it is distended or is undistended. Distended means that it is stretched. When the urinary system has got urine, for example, the urinary bladder is storing an ample amount of urine, then the urothelium is in distended form or stretched form. When the bladder is empty, then it is in undistended form. It contains almost 6 to 8 layers of cells. Its basal cell layers, that is those cells which are present just attached to the basement membrane, are cuboidal shape, and those which are present over the basal layer are polygonal in shape. The superficial cells or the topmost cells are very large and they are dome shaped. Some of the cells contain the distended urothelium appears to contain only 2 to 3 cell layers, and the cells are stretched. The topmost cells appear almost flattened. The slides prepared in the microscope are obviously of undistended or collapsed urinary bladder, because the organism is not alive at the time of formation of the slides of its tissues. So obviously the urinary bladder is not distended. Therefore, usually the slides we see in the microscope are of undistended urinary bladder. Here you can see two nuclei in the dome-shaped cell. There are certain special varieties of epithelial cells known as neuroepithelial cells and myoepithelial cells. Neuroepithelial cells are tall columnar cells and have cilia or stereocilia on their free surface. That is their apical domain. They have got specialized sensory receptors. They are found in taste buds. They have got sensory receptors, therefore, the word neuro is added to the epithelial cells. That is, they have got certain connection or specialization related to the nervous system. The myoepithelial cells contain actin and myosin. Actin and myosin are contractile filaments. They are found around the salivary, that is, those glands which secrete saliva. Lacrimal, that is the gland responsible for the production of tears in the eyes, and sweat glands which are present in our body in our epidermis and produce sweat. The contraction of these myoepithelial cells assist in the flow of secretions into the channels, and therefore the secretions come at the required place or at the required location. This is a hand-drawn diagram taken from the link given in this slide. It shows that the myoepithelial cells surround the secretory end piece in the glands. Therefore, when they contract, the secretory end piece contracts and pushes the secretions into the ducts, and then the secretions reach to the required location. My dear students, stay tuned to my channel and click the notification button, because in the upcoming lectures, I am going to discuss the polarity of epithelial cells. Allah Hafiz for now. Stay happy and stay blessed. And remember me in your prayers.